So this is what started it all, guys. A little bit of leak on the roof. We said, that's strange. We don't remember it quite being that big, right?
Yeah.
So, we then figured out that it is above, that's under the kids' bathroom, right? It's probably a little dark, but it'll get lighter, don't worry. So the first thing I decided to do was replace the toilet. Now this probably happened because my son clogged the toilet and he may or may not have accidentally flushed twice, which makes it overflow, you know? And so water probably just got through there in whatever places. So the first thing I did was pull out the toilet in preparation for buying one today. Now all of these screws are not really tightening up. I don't know how that works, if that's a square piece under the plywood or something that this attaches to or something like that, but I don't want to pull up this entire plywood. This isn't the time for the full reno here, which is the room that needs the reno the most with this really crappy sink and stuff. So I just said, well, at least I want to do the floor while I'm at it, just while I have the toilet out. Not that it's even going to be permanent. I'm doing a cheap floor. I'm going to do a peel and stick. I'm just going to try something real simple. Just to get us by for another year. So I pulled up all the original, what do you call it, vinyl or linoleum. A little bit of moldish stuff here and there from the toilet leaks over the years. And so I went ahead and pulled it all up. I scraped for like 2 or 3 hours for, you know, some of the some of it came up perfectly clean. Some of it had just junk. So I just ripped up that floor. It came up pretty easy, but cleaning it took a long time. Then I took the Ryobi sander with the big long battery and I sanded the whole thing. It was easier than I thought. That kind of smoothed everything out. So now I'm waiting for Home Depot to open at 9. Of course, I was there at 6 a.m. Oops, New Year's Day. And I'm sick, by the way, you can tell. I'm going to buy the 12x12 peel and stick sheets. It's real cheap, real kind of temporary, really, is how we're looking at it. And I'm going to go ahead and do sheets and then put in the new toilet matching the one that we got in our master bedroom so it flushes real good and stuff like that. I might put a double white silicone here. What I mean is, right now I might do a thin bead into the crack, and then I might do, and then I'm going to do a bead over the tiles later to seal it all in. But where I have some real big cracks, I might just do kind of a double safety silicone in there, just to kind of try and protect anything from getting in there too much. That's pretty thick over there. I don't know if I can do that. But mainly the toilet area, kind of seal it a little bit better and see how easy this peel and stick is, if the walls are even straight. And I don't know how that's going to go. And once the floor's in, then we're good to go with the toilet. Super easy. I wasn't expecting to tackle the floor. Oh my God, I just woke up too. I wasn't expecting to tackle the floor today. But I was actually up at 11:52 last night, just finishing it. Then I got to go in just in time to see the new year in the family room on the TV. So I'm waiting for Home Depot to open. I'm going to go buy some supplies and try my first peel and stick floor. I'll get a few clips of that and we'll see just how easy it is, or if it's not quite as easy as it seems. All right, guys, I'll see you in a little bit. I'll just show you samples of this stuff here. This is what came off. And maybe they used some kind of little paste or glue on it. Let me try and show you the slightly like moldish one. Oh, I think it's probably locked in that bag over there. Hold on. There, I don't want to touch it too much. You can just see it wasn't like crazy and it was not through any of the plaster in the kitchen. But you could just see that it's been moist there for a while. So that's why I kind of did the sanding and take off all the surface stuff. The sander did have a filter, by the way. If you're saying, dude, that stuff will kill you. Maybe. This is a sweet Ryobi kit with the big battery right now. And it has a catch bag, of course. And I probably need to replace this now or scrape off all that junk from the floors. But this was a really sweet sander. This is one of my, probably my favorite Ryobi tool, actually, out of the whole collection. Alright guys, I got the first layer of silicone down, real happy. This is going to be under tile. Sealed all the gaps, big gaps, all the way around between the tub. Especially big gaps here. Even did the crease of the plywood. They're probably not even necessary, but you know, what the hell. I'm doing everything else. And a little bit there, that's not really a water concern area. And plugged all this. And under here, well, I want to get rid of that little ridge under there. So I'm ready for to go buy the tile pieces in a few minutes when Home Depot opens. And then I'd probably do another bead of silicone, double protection. Actually, I'm going to do that too. I forgot about that. Just for whatever, because I just don't have time to replace this right now. So I'll just seal it up. What the hell. All right, we're getting there. Never done a bathroom floor before. We'll see. All right, guys. So some parts. I got a little bleach. Cheap bleach, $2. Just to bleach out the floor and the little corners that were a little moist, just to make 100% sure, kill everything there. I got my favorite toilet gasket, which is not the wax. It's a better one. I used it on my other toilet. It works great. A new hose, because the hose that came out was all kinked and leaking. So you got fresh seals in there, which is really nice. An extra tube of the white for on top of it. And then this self-stick vinyl tile. Now this will be interesting to see if this works. To see how hard it is to install. And went with the grays because we do got a gray theme a little bit. And we'll just upgrade the place later. We wanted to do the cabinet, as I might have mentioned, because that was yesterday. But you know, we're not going to go that deep right now. I don't want to rip apart the whole bathroom. So let me see if I can place some of these tiles, see how it looks. So the first thing I kind of see is I just do a test fit with the backing intact and just see, looks like my bathroom is pretty square. It looks pretty good. And of course, I'll only have to trim this one, which is a little overlap. And I'm not going to trim this side, of course. I want a nice clean line. I'll trim the inner side. And I'm not too worried about the edges there. So I'm going to start at this corner, tuck and squeeze, and we'll just see where we get. I expect this to be pretty easy, guys. Easier than I thought. I mean, hell, this is about $30 for the box of tile. You want it real tight. Very easy to tighten up. Oh, yeah, really nice, dude. Look how tight those lines are. And you'll just press it all later. Wow, if I knew I could do my bathroom floors for $30 this easily, I would have already done them. I'm going to have to cut out the hole, of course, no big deal. I'm going to go ahead and keep going on this. Done 3 hours later, the brand new bathroom floor. I decided I'm not going to caulk on top of it right now. I think the bottom caulk is real good, and I think it would just mess up the whole look. Also, the brand new Kohler toilet with the 360-degree plunger. Style. This is the same one that we put in the master bath when we moved in, and it flushes really fast. Boom. No twirling and whirling. So all done, got every little bolt cover done, everything like that. No leaks for now, as long as I don't open this too far and then it drips, but it's fine. So, mission done. Bathroom received makeover. First day of the year. And we'll see you guys later.